practice of recording transactions in the journal. This is called journalizing. So there are three steps we need to follow in journalizing. The first step is identify the accounts that are affected and the type of accounts that are affected. So remember in our earlier discussion, at least two accounts are affected, but there could be more. So when you're looking through these transactions, make sure that you are identifying every account that is affected and what type of account that is. And then you can determine whether each account is increased or decreased by using the rules of debits and credits that we talked about in the previous video. And the last step is to record the transaction in the journal, including a brief explanation. And after step two, you would determine whether it's going to be a debit or a credit in the journal, and then you would record it. So let's look at the general format of a journal entry. So I've laid out the parts here. The first part of a journal entry is the date of the transaction. So I don't really have a date, so I'm going to use just X's to determine or to signify day and year, or day and month, depending on your journal. The second part of the journal entry is where we list the account names and the explanation in that column. So we always list the debited account name first. Now remember, assets is not an account. That is a category. So when we say account name, we mean cash, or accounts payable, or accounts receivable. Whatever account is being debited. And also recall from our rules that a debit can make some accounts increase, and a debit can make some accounts decrease. So that's the point of those first three steps that we talked about earlier. And then you would list the debited amount, the dollar amount. The second part of the journal entry, remember there's always a debit and always a credit because we want our debits to equal our credits. We list our credited account name. And notice that I've indented it just a little bit here. The credited account name is always indented on that second line, as well as the dollar amount is always indented as well. So this being said here, if we had had a compound entry, meaning there's more than one debit and or more than one credit, we always list all the debits first and then we list our credits.